I first saw this building in 1991. That fireplace was not there. In 94, we did archaeology here under all the floors, so we had a chance to look at the layout of the hearth and all of that. We saw right away, wait a minute, this is a very large thing. And we found evidence in there of all kinds of uses to which this fireplace was put. Under the floor, we found all kinds of animal bones. That was real standard in those days. You threw your garbage under the floor. You know, you'd lift up a floorboard and just chuck it, you know. Also, we found, therefore, lots of rat bones. And I can tell you how many little scapulae from rats we found. But we also found evidence of hard coal, slag from blacksmithing operations and all kinds of stuff. So what that indicates is this is multi-purpose here. Probably the Overfield slept here. Their two kids would have slept in a loft. They probably slept here. All the artifact material that you see is almost entirely original. Very few reproduction items in here. So this is all stuff that's been collected over the years, and it's all of the time period of 1808, including things like the sausage grinder up there. Yeah, you throw the meat in there and you turn the crank. The reason it's up there is I was in here one day taking a tour through and I looked down and here's little Johnny with his hand in that thing and starting to turn the crank. Oof. Not good. Now, what you see in this case is very interesting because all of the bits and pieces of china that you see in here, okay, that is all stuff that came from the floor. And every time you go out in the backyard and there's a rain, there are little bits of china that you find out there. And this tells a very interesting story. Now the whole pieces that you see, those are just to show the type of china that it was. Now what this tells us, in its day, this was very pricey stuff. Some of this was made in China, some in England. That white stuff, very, very pricey. So Overfield is not running run-down, dilapidated bar. We know Overfield, for example, when he comes out here, what he's doing to make a living is he's hunting deer, and he's selling the deer skins. And the meat, he traded, bartered to his neighbors. Now, there's even an account of how he did it. What he would do is he starts upstream in the Miami River in a boat, a flat-bottomed boat, sort of like a canoe. It's called a pirogue. And he puts a torch in the front of that. And he drifts down the river. The deer come down to drink at night, and they stop and look at this flame. Boom! Nowadays we call that spotlighting, right. And that gets you several years into pokey, mm-hmm. If you do it. The name of this contraption is a weasel. This is the weasel, and that sound is the pop.
Pop goes the weasel.
That's where the nursery rhyme comes from.
Right on.
Yeah, isn't that cool?
Yes, it is. Actually,
and what they would do is, women would be doing this, and of course you're bored to tears doing this. So you're doing it, and you're thinking up songs because of the rhythm, and you make up nonsense songs. And that's why the nursery rhymes got all those silly verses about cobblers, benches, and monkeys, and I don't know what all. Overfield comes out here, and by 1808, he's built this tavern. And people are flooding this area. So this is a jumping place right here. You want to lock the booze up.
Oh, yeah.
So when Overfield goes to bed, he doesn't have to worry about the guests tippling. The most common coin out here was this. And there are no smaller coins. So what you do is you go to the blacksmith and keep an eye on him while he does it. And he cuts this coin this dollar into four pieces. So you take that quarter and you cut that in half. So now you have eight pieces. And that's why the pirate's parrot is always running around saying, pieces of eight, pieces of eight, pieces of eight. What is 100 divided by 8? 12 and a half. This one guy tells the story of a court session that was held in Overfield's Tavern. And he says, the court is meeting upstairs. That's this room.
All right, can you come over here and talk to me by the screen as loud as you can?
That was Derek.
All right.
Sorry.
Do you care if I go over to the bar and have a drink? Or is it closed?
Are you picking up anything at all?
Don't know yet. We'll find out on this one. It's still really... we'll get to see if we can find something a little more clear than that. Nobody can, yeah. So nobody can have a drink.
The bar's closed, people.
Is that you, Benjamin? Are you the one saying the bar is closed?
Has it been closed for a long time? Yeah, that's clear.
That's a good one.
That's the most clear one so far.
Wow, that sounds like an older guy.
So get my tool. Almost sounds like it says get my tool back or get my toolbox. Box. That one's pretty clear. That's the kind that we like to get that you don't really have to guess. You turn the light on me.
Because he did go back there.
But that was before.
Oh, wait, that was. It's like, you turn the light on me.
You turn the light on me. The light's on upstairs. You heard a bump? I've been here since I've been sitting down here. I just was trying to figure out what it was, and being that it's raining and windy, that's what I was trying to decide. But we'll go up there here in a little bit, so we'll be able to hear it more clear. See? Boom.
smoke someone walking up here.
I've been hearing it, for sure. Did you cook any birds over there? Cook any turkey or deer? Maybe rabbit?
Oh, there's a pretty pair of shoes for you, sir.
Oh, like you. I haven't heard nothing since I've been up here.
This is Josh from Doorways Investigations Group, and I am braving the darkness. So far, nothing's really happening a lot. Earlier, we had somebody walking down here when nobody was in there. So we'll see what happens.
Sounds like footsteps in there. Is anybody out there? Can you tell me why you're here? What did you do when you were here? Did you help work here? Or were you like a seller? I think I keep hearing voices, but I'm not sure. Do a lot of people come here to stay?
If you want to play some poker, cross through that red right here. Do this. Let me know. Just follow me and we'll go play some poker. I bet you on the first hand, I'll bet you 12 and a half cents. That's fucking ridiculous.
Oh.
That was pretty funny.
12 and a half cents must have been worth a lot back then.
He's like, all right, let's play. 12 and a half cents. Is this 12 and a half cents?
No, that's a quarter.
Or this one right here?
That's a quarter.
The little one.
It's going off in 12 and a half cents again.
We can play checkers.
Oh, very good at that, though. You probably win 12 and a half cents.
You know, you've got a chance to do something here that's really kind of important. Ever since your tavern got rediscovered, which is some years ago now, it's been a museum. And what it is, it's a place that's kind of a tribute to you. Because those of us who've come after you think history is really important. And we really want to know a lot about you, your time, how you lived, and things like that. That's kind of hard to do because a lot of records weren't kept. And we want to really give you and your time a lot of attention. We want to know more about it so we can pass it on. Because, you know, that's what history's all about. Wasn't much maybe for you. You guys were too busy out here. You were too busy building. You were too busy growing. But we want to preserve the memory of what you did. And we want to know more about it, because if we do, then we can do a better job of that. And that's why we have these sessions where we want to talk to you. Think about what we're trying to do. Because in the future, when we're all gone, we might want people to know about what we've done when we're here. It's only recently that people are doing what the folks here are doing tonight, trying to get your side of this story.
On the count of three, touch my knee. One, two, three. Just come right up to my knee. Don't be afraid. That's right. So you're right by me.
Well, this house was built in 1973. There is an old old Indian mound out back. We've got lots of artifacts from there through the years. I've lived here since the house was built, and there's been like an Indian looking guy, young guy in maybe late teens, early 20s. Long hair.
We do have a camera.
And he doesn't do anything to hurt anyone. But he does like knock over things, plants, cups.
And you've seen this guy you've seen him with your own eyes?
Oh yeah. Yeah.
Could you tell me what kind of Indian you are?
What tribe are you from?
If there's somebody in here, could you let us know somehow?
This is what she does.
Are you scaring the dog right now? Making the dog mad?
And you notice she's not barking now? We're asking questions, she starts barking.
Mm-hmm. She's freaked out right now. She never sits on my lap.
What is that?
You know, I've been here most of my life. You've watched me grow up. You've been here the whole time. I already know this. You coming for you tonight?
That's like a sentence.
Mm-hmm.
What's the noise?
What?
Hear it?
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
I think I'm good at hearing.
Out. How many times was that?
That was more. Stack that up. So it was like 9 or 10.
What the?
What was that?
Really?
It's piss.
Why am I hearing words being said?
Did you hear that too? Because I heard it, man. And I wasn't going to say anything because I thought I was losing my mind.
I am hearing words being said in a real low tone.
Was it like a man?
I'm hearing different ones at different times.
What do you hear?
I can't make it out. I heard that too, Brandon.
Did you hear it?
Yes, I did.
What did it sound like to you?
Something being moved?
Yeah.
Something scraping?
It sounded like something slid across the
yep.
counter or something.
It's probably moving. Stuff.
It sounded like something glass moving across the counter. Like
I try to keep all my glass away from the edge because he does slide things off. You know, to get my attention, I guess.
That scared the shit out of me. I heard it plain as day, man.
Camera.
Go check and make sure all the glasses.
Camera should have picked it up, so the sound.
All the glasses what?
Are away from the edge of the counter, so they don't fall. So they,
could it have been that?
See, because he slides stuff.
Indeed.
That is exactly it. Mm-hmm. It made me and Brandon both snap our hands around. Wow, Terry.
I told you.
What was that?
I don't know, but it scared her. She just jumped around.
No. She hit under her. Like it hit the. I felt the vibration on my foot.
What happened?
She jumped and ran. I don't know. Something just hit down.